He will speak about Fisher photosynthesis over iron-based catalysts with syngas containing H2S, the effect of catalyst pretreatment and the additions of manganese. Co-authors are Y. Kobayashi, M. Jiang, and M. Yamada.
Thank you for the kind introduction. I would like to present our research of Fisher photosynthesis over iron-based catalyst with syngas containing hydrogen sulfide, effects of catalyst pretreatment and addition of manganese. This figure shows a flow diagram of a liquid fuel synthesis from various carbon resources. In order to make synthetic fuels competitive, it is important to utilize small-scale carbon resources. For this purpose, the process should be simple as possible. The conventional catalysts are easily poisoned by the sulfur compounds, such as hydrogen sulfide. In order to avoid sulfur poisoning, they are removed by the desulfurizer unit before synthesis. Therefore, development of a sulfur tolerant catalyst without desulfurizer unit contributes to a smaller scale plant. It has been reported that an addition of these compounds to iron catalysts eases the sulfur poisoning. Manganese addition is most effective among them. Iron manganese is known as a selective catalyst for the light olefin synthesis. Pretreatment by carbon monoxide, then hydrogen, or syngas has an effect on the light olefin synthesis. It has been also reported that iron manganese catalyst is less active in the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis than iron copper potassium catalyst. A structure of iron manganese catalyst has been investigated by XRD and mass power emission spectroscopy. These results indicate the formation of various kinds of iron phases during the synthesis, including solid solutions of iron and manganese oxides. However, correlation between the structure and activity has not been made clear. Our object is to develop the sulfur. Our object is to develop the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis catalyst with a sulfur tolerance. In the present contribution, we try to improve the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis activity of iron manganese catalyst. We paid our attention to effects of manganese addition and catalyst pretreatment. The present work also tried to make clear the correlation between activity and the surface fine structure of iron manganese catalyst. All the catalysts were prepared by the precipitation method. Iron and manganese nitrates were used as precursor materials. Iron manganese ratio shown here were prepared. For comparison, iron copper potassium catalyst is also prepared. Activity measurements were carried out using a fixed bed flow reactor. Before synthesis, catalyst was pretreated in syngas, carbon monoxide, or hydrogen. The following presentation, unless otherwise stated, the catalyst was pretreated in syngas. Fischer trop synthesis was carried out at these conditions. At first, we examined the activity in the absence of hydrogen sulfide. After reaching the steady state activity, hydrogen sulfide was introduced to the reaction mixture. A typical example is shown here. This figure shows the CO conversion rate as a function of time on stream. And the catalyst used is iron manganese 1 by 6. After synthesis for 15 hours, hydrogen sulfide was introduced, and the synthesis further continued for more than 10 hours. From here, we call this period poisoning duration. The liquid products were condensed with an isotope and were analyzed after the synthesis. Effect of manganese addition on Fischer-Tropsch synthesis activity of iron catalyst has been reported by Penrine et al. Their results show that CO conversion rate per mole of iron increases with increasing manganese content. Olefin content in hydrocarbon products increases also. However, effect of manganese addition on the following 2 points have not been investigated yet. At first, we examined the effect of manganese addition on the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis activity of iron catalyst. This figure shows hydrocarbon yield normalized to mole of iron and the chain growth probability of iron manganese catalyst as a function of iron manganese ratio. Hydrocarbon yield shown here were obtained in the absence of hydrogen sulfide. This is iron catalyst and this is manganese. As shown here, by the addition of small amount of manganese, hydrocarbon yield significantly decreases. Further addition of manganese, on the contrary, increases hydrocarbon yield. Hydrocarbon yield of manganese is quite low. Chain growth probability of iron manganese catalyst decreases monotonously with increasing manganese content. Here we compare these results with iron copper potassium catalyst. Both hydrocarbon yield and chain growth probability of iron manganese catalyst is smaller than iron copper potassium catalyst. Then we examine the effect of manganese addition on the sulfur tolerance of iron catalyst. This figure shows the deactivation rate of iron manganese catalyst in the presence of hydrogen sulfide as a function of iron manganese ratio. X and Y axis indicates us poisoning duration and CO conversion rate normalized to mole of iron. As shown here, by introducing hydrogen sulfide, CO conversion rate of iron catalyst decreases immediately. The rate of iron catalyst drops to 10% of its initial value at this time. By addition of the small amount of manganese, significantly decreases the deactivation rate. Further addition of manganese decreases the deactivation rate. Here I will show you the result of iron copper potassium catalyst. The deactivation rate of iron manganese is much smaller than iron copper potassium catalyst. Therefore, addition of manganese significantly improves the sulfur tolerance of iron catalyst, while it depresses the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis activity. So the question is, why manganese addition depresses the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis activity? In order to make this point, we examined effect of manganese addition on surface area and surface composition of iron catalyst. The obtained results are shown here. Y-axis indicates surface area and surface iron manganese ratios determined by XPS respectively. In this figure, surface area and surface composition of the catalyst before pretreatment are shown here. As mentioned above, by the addition of small amount of manganese, hydrocarbon yield significantly decreases. However, as shown here, this increases the surface area. Further addition of manganese decreases the surface area to the same level as iron catalyst. surface iron manganese ratio and freezes monotonously with increasing manganese content. From these results, we calculated the number of surface iron atoms, and then we estimated the turnover frequency of these catalysts. That is, CO conversion rate was normalized to the number of surface iron atoms. This figure shows the number of surface iron atoms and the turnover frequency of iron manganese catalysts as a function of iron manganese ratio. CO conversion rate used for the calculation of the turnover frequency was obtained in the absence of hydrogen sulfide. From this figure, it is obvious that the turnover frequency of iron catalysts significantly decreases by the addition of small amount of manganese. Although further addition of manganese increases the turnover frequency, they are still less than 50% of iron catalyst. These results suggest that interaction species between iron and manganese, interaction species between iron and manganese are formed by manganese addition to iron catalyst. In order to obtain information how to improve the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis activity of iron manganese catalyst, we further examined these interaction species. The structure of iron manganese catalyst before and after synthesis has been investigated by means of XRD and Messbauer emission spectroscopy. Messbauer study by Jagi et al. Suggests that various kinds of iron phases are present during the synthesis. They also noted that the solid solutions of iron and manganese oxide are formed during the synthesis. However, correlation between these phases and the activity is not clear. This is maybe due to the following two reasons. Therefore, we tried in-situ surface observation by drift using carbon monoxide as a probe molecule. This figure shows the temperature profile of drift measurements. At first, we observed the catalyst surface under the synthesis condition. That is, drift spectra were recorded under the flow of syngas at 573 Kelvin and 1.2 megapascal. However, in the case of iron catalyst, no IR bands were observed in the CO stretching region except for the gas phase carbon monoxide. This may be due to the rapid dissociation of adsorbed carbon monoxide during the synthesis. After flushing by helium at room temperature, no IR bands were observed. Then we recorded the spectra during temperature program desorption, because it is possible that the recombination of the adsorbed species occurs to form adsorbed carbon monoxide. But first, we examined iron catalyst. This is one set of the drift spectra obtained with iron catalyst. The temperature increases from 293 Kelvin to 573 Kelvin. As shown here, with increasing temperature, a doublet band appears here and a broad band appears here. These bands are assigned to carbon monoxide adsorbed on iron metal sides. Here we show the IR band positions of an iron carbonyl cluster composed of three iron atoms. The IR band positions of IR band position appeared in the spectra are consistent well with iron carbonyl cluster. This indicates that the cluster size of iron metals in iron catalyst is very small. Then we examine the effect of manganese addition on the adsorption state of carbon monoxide. The obtained spectra are shown here. three sharp bands and a broad band appear in the spectrum. They are also assigned to carbon monoxide, a sodium ion metal site. This arrow indicates the IR band position of carbon monoxide absorbed on ion catalyst mentioned above. The absorption state of carbon monoxide on ion metal sites in ion manganese catalyst is quite different from ion catalyst. Compared with IR band positions of carbon monoxide absorbed on ion single crystal surface, these bands are assigned to linear bleached and multiply bleached carbon monoxide. This indicates that the cluster size of ion metals in ion manganese catalyst is larger than ion catalyst. Please remind that the surface area of ion manganese 1 by 6 is comparable with ion catalyst. Therefore, the difference in the cluster size between ion manganese catalyst and ion catalyst may be caused by the interaction between ion and manganese. Interaction between iron and manganese. It has been reported that the distribution of iron phases during iron phases in iron catalyst changes strongly depending on the pretreatment. In the case of iron manganese catalyst, carbon monoxide exclusively absorbed on iron metal sites. Therefore, it is possible that the activity and selectivity of ion manganese catalyst also can be modified by the pretreatment. This figure compares the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis activity of variously pretreated ion manganese with ion copper potassium catalyst. Hydrocarbon yield shown here were obtained in the absence of hydrogen sulfide. As shown here, by carbon monoxide pretreatment, hydrocarbon yield and chain growth probability of iron manganese catalyst increase. They are comparable with iron copper potassium catalyst. Finally, we examined the sulfur tolerance of iron manganese catalyst pretreated by carbon monoxide. This figure compares the deactivation rate of iron manganese catalyst with iron copper potassium catalyst. The deactivation rate of iron manganese catalyst does not depend on the pretreatment. It is obvious that the deactivation rate of iron manganese catalyst pretreated by carbon monoxide is much smaller than iron copper potassium catalyst. In conclusion, the liquid hydrocarbon synthesis activity of iron manganese catalyst can be improved by the carbon monoxide pretreatment to the same level as iron copper potassium catalyst. The iron manganese catalyst pretreated by carbon monoxide is also superior in the sulfur tolerance. This work was supported by research for the future program of Japan Society for the Promotion of Science under the project Synthesis of Ecological High Quality Transportation Fuels. Thank you for your attention.
Other questions?
I was wondering whether you observed any changes in the selectivity to the unsaturated copper.
No change was observed during the in the presence of hydrogen sample.
Of olefin. The different amounts of manganese, did you notice changes in olefin production?
I guess by the addition of manganese, olefin content increased.
Yeah, one of the statements was that on iron manganese, the cluster sizes of the iron were larger. I wondered whether the decrease in the CO stretching frequency might also be due to an interaction of your CO with your manganese oxide or your manganese which is present. Is anything known about that?
So we have observed no IR bonding out of this carbon monoxide absorbed on manganese oxide after pretreatment or during the synthesis. Before pretreatment, that is in the oxide state, carbon monoxide scrap are weakly absorbed on manganese oxide. But after pretreatment, structure changes, and carbon monoxide exclusively absorbed on iron.
I have a question concerning the hydrogen sulfide injection in your system. And you showed us very clearly that it's the activity is dropping down. And do you have any suggestion how to reverse it back? Or just throw it out? How would it reverse it back?
So,
the vibration of the
application phenomena is virtual, so we cannot succeed in the recovery of this activity.
So you could not return it back to the initial level, right?
No.
Okay.
Referring to the question of Herr Price, I remember our experiments when we added manganese oxide to the iron catalyst, and the selectivity of the alpha olefins was much higher due to the addition of the manganese, yes? So in principle, in terms of reaction mechanisms, the secondary reactions, yes? The olefins are the primary one, the alpha, the secondary reactions are somehow inhibited through the manganese addition to the catalyst. But you remember our beer, the alpha olefins, this is a high manganese catalyst.
You showed with one of your slides alpha values about 0.9. I was wondering if those are alpha phases for your olefins or for hydrocarbons, including paraffin.
Sorry.
On one of your slides, you showed alpha value. Yeah, I'm wondering if those are alpha phases for olefins or paraffin.
This alpha included paraffin and olefins. Both paraffin and olefins.
If you were to take the olefins by themselves, or
sorry, you have not suggested that change was probably the only olefin.
Another question? Well, let's thank our speaker. That concludes the symposium. I thank all of you for staying this late. I've enjoyed this.
Thank you.
Thank you.